என்ன கவிதா ப்ளஸ் 2 ரிசல்ட் வந்துருச்சு அடுத்து என்ன செய்ய போற
தர்மபுரி டொன்போஸ்கோ காலேஜ்ல சேரலாம் நினைக்கிறேன்
எத்தனையோ காலேஜ் இருந்தோம் ஏன் டொன்போஸ்கோ காலேஜ்ல சேரணும்னு ஆசை பண்ற
டொன்போஸ்கோ காலேஜ் அமைதியான அட்டகாசமான சூழல்ல அமைஞ்சிருக்கு டொன்போஸ்கோ காலேஜ்ல இளங்கலை முதுகலை ஆய்வு படிப்பு பிஎட் படிப்புன எல்லாமே இருக்கு அது மட்டுமா இன்னும் நிறைய வசதிகள் காலேஜ்ல இருக்கே
அப்படியா
டொன்போஸ்கோ காலேஜ்ல சான்றிதழ் பட்டப்படிப்போட விளையாட்டு துறையில தனி பயிற்சி பேண்ட் வாத்திய பயிற்சின்னு பல இருக்கு டொன்போஸ்கோ காலேஜ்ல திறமை மிக்க ஆசிரியர்கள் தான் பயிற்சி கொடுக்கறாங்க நம்ம டொன்போஸ்கோ காலேஜ்லயே முகாம் நடத்தி வேலை வாய்ப்பையும் ஏற்படுத்தி தராங்க அது மட்டுமா டொன்போஸ்கோ காலேஜ் சலேஷி தந்தையர்களால நடத்தப்படுற பன்னாட்டு தொண்டு நிறுவனம் 12ஆம் வகுப்புல 225 க்கு குறைவாவோ 450 க்கு அதிகமாவோ மார்க் வாங்குனவங்களுக்கு முன்னுரிமையும் ஸ்காலர்ஷிப்பும் தராங்க
நீ சொல்றத பார்த்தா என் எதிர்காலம் சிறப்பா அமையணும்னா நானும் டொன்போஸ்கோ காலேஜ்ல தான் சேரணும்ங்கற
ஆமாமா இதெல்லாம் இல்லாம மதிய உணவு திட்டம் பேருந்து வசதி மருத்துவ வசதி கவுன்சிலிங் வசதி கலைத்திறன் வெளிப்பாட்டு பயிற்சின்னு டொன்போஸ்கோ காலேஜ்ல நிறைய இருக்கு டொன்போஸ்கோ காலேஜ்ல படிச்ச மாணவர்கள் பல பேர் இப்ப வாழ்க்கையில உயர்ந்த நிலையில சிறந்த முறையில இருக்காங்க இதுல இன்னொரு சிறப்பு என்னன்னு தெரியுமா டொன்போஸ்கோ பிஎட் காலேஜ் ஒவ்வொரு வருடமும் மாநில அளவுல முதலிடமும் தங்க பதக்கமும் வாங்குறாங்க
அப்படியா சரி சரி முகவரியை சொல்ல
டொன்போஸ்கோ கல்லூரி அதியமான் புறவழி சாலை சோகத்தூர் தர்மபுரி 944-3640-4446 944-3640-4447 பிஎட் 93852-01369
A pleasant morning to all, respected chief guest of the day, Dr. Geeta, learned professors from the Department of Commerce, particularly the HOD and the former HOD and the organizers and interested learners. I am indeed pleased to give the inaugural address for this webinar. I deemed it this as my privilege. I am very much pleased to know that the Department of Commerce of our college is organizing various programs during the academic year. In this peculiar situation of COVID-19, we have come out with some innovative programs as the world proceeds, goes along with the science and technology, and our department has organized a day and hour webinar, A Journey to the Corporate World. My dear friends, whether we like it or not, we are every day bound by the corporate world, and we are attracted and we deal with most of the things, and they determine many of the things. Though I am not a committed person to talk about on this topic, we are glad our resource person, Dr. Geeta, will enlighten the participants on this topic. From the point of management, as a principal, on behalf of the management committee, I like to appreciate and express my gratitude to the resource person for having accepted to be our resource person for this day. And I thank the HOD and all the members of the department for having taken this step to organize this webinar today. And I also express my gratitude at this juncture to all the technical staff and all the people who are connected with this. I wish and pray that this and our program will be a useful and learning program for all the participants. I wish God's choicest blessing on the resource person, organizers, technicians, and the participants. May God bless you. Have a wonderful time. God bless you all. Thank you.
Respected dignitaries, faculty, and my dear participants, very good morning to you all. I am I. James, Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce of this college. It gives me great pleasure to introduce and welcome our chief guest, Dr. R. Geeta, Dean, School of Commerce, associate professor and head department of BCom Honors, Guru Nanak College, Autonomous Chennai, for this webinar on a journey to corporate life. Teaching is the noble profession. I never teach my pupils. I only attempt to provide the conditions in which they can learn. Said by Albert Einstein. Our research person is working in Guru Nanak College, Chennai for past 16 years. She has 21 years of teaching experience. Her area of specialization is cost and management. Madam has acted as research person for various national seminars and conferences. And also, Madam published research articles nearly 15 in national and international reputed journals. Now, I request our distinguished research person to address the participants.
Good morning. Thank you, Father, and thank you, James, for the wonderful introduction of myself. Thank you. The topic is, as Father said, it's a very quite interesting, and every student has to travel the corporate world. So first, I would like to start with a quote on Vivekananda. Education is manifestation of the perfection what a man has. Really, the education has to impart a lot of things to the students' community so that they can frame a good society indeed. This is possible only through framing a good curriculum. This curriculum should create self-respect, confidence to the students' community so that they are able to stand on his or own feet. The curriculum should be designed in such a way it gives motivation, encouragement, practical knowledge, and various skills which develop them to stand on their own feet. This transition is possible only through our teachers' community. As in the introduction, James sir told, teaching is a noble profession. According to Henry Brooks Adams, teachers affect eternity. No one can tell where their influence stops. See, I have a strong opinion. Teachers can impact lot of things to the students' community. If once one idea or one skill is developed in one, it will transit to a long journey and develop among many persons, and it will have no end at all. So we cannot search the where it ends. It will be going on. It will be carried through many generations also. As a teacher, we have a corporate social responsibility to create a good culture, good attitude, good character among students, and we can build a strong nation. So I have a strong opinion. The teachers are the real role models to the students, and they can impact a lot of things among the students. Now, we can go for a pedagogy of education system which prevailed in ancient India. Everyone would have heard about this system, Gurukul system of education. This is the ancient traditional pedagogy where it has a lot of advantages. This, I can share a few points. What are they? One is your practical knowledge. In ancient days, many would go to the guru's place, and they will stay there and will learn a lot of skills. So they can learn the practical knowledge from the gurus. This pedagogy will have a few more advantages also. It cultures your value-based education, not only academic skill. So value-based system where the human being is developed into a good-hearted person. More than that, in this system, the teacher and the student have a very good relationship. I can quote one example also that in olden days, we would have heard of in Idikasas, the Ekalivan who himself sacrificed his finger to the guru. There was such a bondage between the teacher and the students. So today, we talk more about socialization. This was one of the important features in the Gurukulam system. because people from different regions join together, stay with the guru, learn lot of things, and this create socialization among themselves. Then they can develop the overall personality. They can take lot of good qualities from the guru. So ultimately, these students are developed into a good personality. So they will be trained to know the whatever the culture and gain the lot of knowledges and everything from the guru. So this system of education was really good and amazing in ancient days. Our ancestors are well predictors. So they've imparted this sort of education. So I feel that nowadays also we follow the same system of education, only in a small rename, that is residential schooling system. In residential schooling system, we can learn a lot of things from the institutions. So in the morning itself, the students are made to wake up in the early mornings. They are giving the coachings. Their skills are identified. They can get a lot of extracurricular knowledge, such as if they are interested in sports, they can take part in sports. If they are interested in culturals, they can take part in culturals. So I was discussing with my student, he was from a CBSE students, and he came from a residential schooling system. He used to give complete Vedas. I asked where you studied. So this was a part of education system where he got in the residential schooling system. So if he or she, whatever the area of interest, he can develop the extracurricular talent from the residential schooling system. That doesn't mean that regular colleges are not giving or not imparting this knowledge. We are also in the regular streams. We are imparting a lot of things. As teachers, we are imparting a lot of things to the students. Apart from academic, every day we are molding the students and we are identifying the interest and we are molding, giving lot of inputs, trainings, suggestions, guidance, and making the students to excel in their own way. So present education system, we are giving lot of exposure to the students. Not only the teachers, the technology also supports the students to gather knowledge from the various fields. Education system provides in India is very good system, and the students are molded with the good academic excellence and also as a good human being. So as a teacher and education system definitely can mold a student. This is my strong thought, which I believe in it. Transition is an ongoing process where everyone would of us would faced in our life in different stages. A student might he would have moved from the final year of school to the early years of college education, where he get lot of knowledge, independent thinking, social awareness. From the college campus, he then move on to the corporate life. But this period, this gap needs a lot of attention, because the student will be pampered till the college campus. Everything is pre-planned. Say, for example, whether it is exams, or conferences, or workshop, or whatever it may be, we are pampering. It is pre-planned. They will be able to do the work. They will be able to learn the work, and they will do it perfectly. But when he or she enters the corporate, 2 days will not be a similar one. Every day, he has to face a lot of challenges, and he has to have the problem-solving techniques. He should be able to communicate, and he or she needs lot of qualities to enter a corporate world. So now, as a teachers, how we are going to bridge the gap between this campus life to the corporate life? So we are going to see what are all the qualities that are required for a corporate field. I would like to share, first, as a teachers, we have to identify what are the requirements of a corporate. Alone, we cannot do that. My job timing is 9 to 4. More than that, beyond that, I will not do any work. Should not be the intention of a teacher. 24/7, he or should have connectivity with the industrial sectors. Analyze what are all the requirements for the industries, because every corporate has its own requirements. One requirement will not be similar for the other corporate. So as a teacher, we should first identify what are the requirements for a corporate. Only then we will be able to mold our students, train our students, and make fit to the corporate life. Then only the student's journey will be peaceful and happy. So this is possible by getting the information from the corporate sector. This is possible only through the connectivity with the industrial sectors or the corporate sectors. So we can contact the HR persons. We can get what are all the requirements of your concern. We can often have interactions with these people. This is one way of getting the data. The other way is we can make a cold calls, which means we can give a call to these through the websites or through whatever may be the mode. We can identify an industry or a corporate. We can give a call to the receptionist and we can ask to connect them to the right person where we can get this sort of information. So this is the another mode where the teachers can get the information. Apart from that, I strongly believe our alumni, the alumni who were already in existing in industries, we can contact them. If there is any new recruitments or openings, we can ask them to inform us and we can have a connectivity with the alumni for the data. So there are a lot of ways to get the information, but one thing, as the teachers, we should be very, very, very active. Especially every day, we can get a lot of information through our emails and WhatsApp. So if we are lazy, if you are not opening, if you are not responding to the emails, definitely the industrial sector also will ignore. One of my friends said the industrial sector has a lot of respect to the teachers because teachers are building nations. So they respect us. In turn, whenever we receive a mail, it is our mandatory to reply to the mail within the 24 hours. This will help us to build a smooth relationship with the industries where we can get a lot of information. So as we teachers, once if you got the data, what are all the requirements of industry, then we can mold our students in the right track. First of all, when a student enters in the first year, either it may be UG or PG, first have a conversation with them, identify his goals, identify his vision, identify his mission, and identify his skill, what all the skill he is having. Then only we can mold the students and track them in the right way. Few skills which I feel very, very important. These are all the few skills, common skills, which a corporate world need. Number one is few skills are personality, communication, teamwork, hard work, problem solving, socialization, self-management, learning, technology savviness, and etiquette. These are all the few skills which a corporate expect from a student. Now, we can see one by one what are all the important things and what is the role of a teacher in molding these skills. Number one will be personality. I would like to quote a Tamil proverb, Alpadi Adaipadi. At the time of interview, within 5 or 10 minutes, the employer should be attracted in the way the candidate has dressed. So this we can call the technical name grooming. So this grooming is very, very important. So he or she should be dressed in a proper way and should be presentable neatly in front of the interviewer. This is very, very more important. So I can give one example. I was working with the College of Aviation where every week there will be 1 or 2 hours of a session. A trainer will be there. He will be giving a lot of trainings on grooming, how to dress, how to behave. Everything will be handled by that particular teacher. At the end of the third year, definitely at the end of first year itself, we can see that students who come from a very, very poor background also will be dressed in a very nice way, will be in a presentable way. So this grooming is more important. As we teachers, we can mold the students to dress them properly. So I can give a few more examples also. A few students are very fond of trendy and they will be in a torn jeans. They like to grow long hair. They used to wear studs. They used to wear some robes in the hand, everything. As a teacher, we can call them. We can counsel them. This role is not good. Your total attire spoils your personality. If you dress neatly and properly, if you carry yourself properly, definitely you will be looking smart. If you give this sort of opinions to the students within 1 or 2 days, definitely he will start grooming and he will come in the right formals. Instead of scolding, instead of giving punishments, if you give a small counseling, definitely, ultimately, the students will start grooming and they will be in a presentable mode. Number two is the attitude and behavior. Really, attitude is an inborn quality and it should come from the small age itself, from the family. More than that, as teachers, we can tune the attitude. If a student misbehaves or anything, we can call them and we can rightly point out this is not right. I can give one example. Once I was discussing with my HR friend, I asked a small question, sir, how will you be selecting a candidate? He told, ma'am, right from entering the door, an entire thing will be watched, and within few seconds, as an interviewer, I will be able to judge the quality of the student. Say, for example, when you're getting inside a room, the student should knock the door and he or she should ask, excuse me, sir. This is the basic manner which a student should have. So if he comes lethargically, that shows his attitude is not good. He is not obedient. He is not giving any importance to the others. So this manners we can develop from the, as a teachers, we can create this manner. Whenever he or she enters the class, we can ask him to ask excuse. We can ask him to say sorry, thanks, few words, which will definitely build a social relationship. Then I ask, then how will you judge his behavior? So once he has entered the interview room, the next is the way of sitting in the chair. So he should keep the file politely on the table. Using his both the hands, he should move the chair, and without making any noise, he should sit. That too, he should wait until the employer says to do so. So this is the behavior he speaks in the interview. So the way of body language he carries, that plays a major role in the selection process. So this grooming, attitude, behavior, everything will be judged within a few minutes, within a 5 minutes. The last one is the confidence. I asked the sir, how will you be able to judge the confidence? He told, ma'am, really when one starts speaking, we need eye to eye contact. If he sees somewhere else and if he's speaking, that shows he is not a self-confident person. If you have a straight eye contact, that shows his confidence level. So the interviewer within 5 minutes judges the personality of a student. As teachers, we can train them, we can groom them, we can create good behaviors, create self-confidence, so which will play a major role as the first phase. The second important skill is communication skill. So my strong opinion is many of the students will be academically strong but lack in communication skill. Especially, they will be very strong in the mother language, but the worldwide accepted global language, English, is very tough to many of us to communicate. The students may be able to read, write, but not be able to communicate. This is only because of the shyness and the frightened or the scared or whatever it may be. So they will not be able to communicate. They will be able to read, write, understand, but not able to communicate. I have experienced first year, second year, the students will be having 80%, 90%, but at the end of the third year, when they go for an interview, they will clear the aptitude test, but they will lose the positions at the communication skill. So what my suggestion is, right from the first year, if we teachers plan, definitely this skill, communication skill, can be developed among the students. As a first set, we can start giving group discussions where the students will be given a topic and we can ask them to participate and deliver the lectures or whatever the views they can share with among the friends. So usually the students will not feel shy to share among the friends with the peer groups. So we can give group discussions. We can organize debates. We can give allot one person as a responsible to be a moderator. So he or she will learn the communication skill. Then as the teachers, I've seen few of us used to go deliver, that's all, come back, which is not quite interesting. I feel always, I say, students, please interact. If you're not interacting, I will give an example. I am taking classes to the asses, not to the students, or I am taking classes to the walls. Definitely, we need a interactive classes. So if we ask the students to participate, to give counterparts, to argue, whether it is pros or cons, whatever it may be, definitely the students can develop the communication skills. One thing, I want to share my personal experience. When I was doing my 8th standard, really till date, I think of my teacher. She is a maths faculty. She don't have any connection with the English, but she is a class teacher. What she did is she made all of us to have the finish off our lunch quickly and to sit and read the Renan Martin grammar book and do a few exercises on grammar. Now we have a lot of platforms. We can search Google synonyms, antonyms, grammar, whatever it may be. We can find things immediately within a minute. But at that time, we don't have that much of technological support. So this Ranil Martin Brahma book has supported me a lot. Now I'm able to write a sentence, communicate without any grammatical mistake. So because till date, after 30 years, I think my teacher was contributed, who made me to give this lecture. So that is what a teacher should play a role. So the next thing, we can make the students daily to read the newspapers, identify few tough words and ask them to refer and find out these synonyms and antonyms so that the vocabulary of the students will ultimately develop. So the communication skills, we can ask them to present, we can ask them to participate, we can give a letters, we can give presentations, everything. We can give a lot of work apart from academic syllabus. The extra works can be given to the students and we can develop the communication skills. One more thing is, my principal always used to say, ma'am, ask the students to talk in English among the peers, to the teachers, to the principal, whomever it may be in the campus. Definitely, this will develop the end of the final year to give a good communication skill. So we can ask the students, even though if they are talking wrong, as teachers, instead of criticizing, we can call them, we can correct them so that they will learn very, very quickly. We can give a lot of counselings. First of all, they should come out from the nutshell and they should be able to communicate. So as teachers, we can definitely mold the students to speak up very good English, whatever it may be the corporate sector requires. It need not be, the student should be able to communicate a very simple, but in a very clear way, whatever he or she had in his mind. So this is what the communication the employer expects. So first we saw the personality, which is more important. Within 5 minutes, the interviewer will judge the personality. Next, he will judge the communication skill by giving a topic to speak. So this is possible not at the sudden moment. Right from beginning, we have to plan, we have to track the students, we have to make the students to communicate. Only then he or she will be able to perform well in the interviews. The next skill is a teamwork. Definitely, I strongly believe alone we cannot do anything. Together, we can achieve a lot. This is possible through the teamworks. So, as I said, the corporate needs socialization. This was done in the curriculum system of education also. So this teamwork is most expected quality of a corporate. So we can give a group projects to the students. So we can make them to mingle with the students and do the work. So when they are allotted a group project, we have to assign the responsibility of each and every student and we have to avoid the conflicts among them. If there is any misunderstanding also, we can call them, we can make them to understand, do the work, complete the task within the scheduled time. So through group projects, definitely we can build a teamwork among the students. So ultimately, if he or she has developed this teamwork, he or she will be very much effective or very much fit to the corporate world. So this is the third skill which a corporate requires. Hard work. Hard work beats talent. This is very, very important thing. Again, I was discussing with the HR manager. So if he or she is not having the communication skill or personality, whatever it may be, but he is a very person of hard work, how will you track, sir? During the time of interview itself, if the employer feels that person is a hard worker and if he is having interest to learn, definitely he will hire the student and they will give a training for this personality or the communication skills. So only thing is, a person should be of able to do hard work. So this hard work is, I asked, sir, how will you judge the hard work, sir? He answered my question, ma'am, we will be asking, so whether you're interested in the night shifts, whether you will be working only the time, 9 to 5, immediately the present generation answer, yes, sir, I'll be working only for 9 to 5. After that, I will not be interested to work. If he is giving that answer, the employer will identify that he is not a person of committed. He is ready to work only for the salary. So commitment and hard work plays a very, very, very important role in the judging. One more thing I want to share here is Rolling Stones gather mass, which means one should stay back in an institution for a long tenure. Only then he or she will be able to understand the nooks and corners of the organization. He can move step by step and can reach the higher level. Here, I would like to share one of my experience. Once I went to a jewelry shop. It is a famous jewelry shop in Chennai. It is GRT Thangamaligai store. I went with my son to purchase few jewelries, and I was interacting with the manager. He was close family friend of us. So I asked, so he started interacting with my son. So he started what you're doing, and he started, so, whether you believe it or not, I joined in this institution during at the age of 16 as an office boy. After that, I did all the work, right from bringing tea to the sales managers or whatever it may be, cleaning, mopping, everything I did at the initial stage. Whether, my dear friends, you believe it or not, now he is the senior manager next to the owner. He is not even an MBA graduate. He is not even a graduate. He told openly, he shared his openly the experience. I'm only a 10th dropout student, but still that he is hiring a very, very, very high position. And also shared one of the things, everyone would have read in the newspapers that Padmanabhapuram Palace, there was a mine, it was tough, they started digging all the jewelries, whatever in the mines, and it has to be valued. This valuation work, the Kerala government called this senior manager to wait. He was literally provided with a 5-star hotel residence, but 2 guards will be front and back. Everything was very tedious, very tough. So it was a lengthy process. And then he was not able to do that. So what he did is he came back to Chennai, sir, I'm not interested. But whether you believe it or not, the Supreme Court gave the order, he is the right person to value the jewelries. He is the right person to value. The Kerala government cannot do anything. Immediately, again, they called, he completed the task. So hard work definitely will reach the students to a longer status. This hard work, and also to stay in the same institution longer period, plays a very, very prominent role. Again, I would like to share, I've read one thing in Japanese. They have a very good thought of environment where the promotions will be considered only on the seniority. So if you stay in the organization at one point of time, definitely you can reach the higher goals. So moving from one institution, from another institution, will not sound good. So it is better to stay, learn whatever the challenges face it, then only you can succeed in your life. This is my opinion. The next quality is the problem solving. Really, problem solving matters must. One, either he or she should be able to find solution. He should not hesitate to find solutions. This is possible only through critical thinking. And also he or she should be a person of independent thinking. So as the students are pampered in the family and the teachers, few students lack in this problem solving, but we can give training of problem solving. We can give research and assignments where the students will be able to identify a problem, find out solutions, collect data, analyze, and from that they will learn the solutions for a problem. Through research assignments, the teachers can guide, they can trigger the problem solving techniques among the students. So this is the most important which the corporate sector expects from the students. The next is the socialization. Really, this is a broad area where socialization is important. Socialization means moving with each other's, creating a good interpersonal relationship among the peer group, not only among the peer group, also in and around the organization. That doesn't mean the interpersonal relation should be healthy and good. So whether it's a male or female, that doesn't matter. They should have a good interpersonal relationship. Definitely only then teamwork is possible in an organization. So this will develop the individual to contribute to the development of the organization. So socialization is also very, very important. Often my principal used to share in every meeting, there should be a line between the students and the teachers. This is also a concept of socialization. We should be friendly to the students. At the same time, the students should not call us to join for a movie or join for a mall or join for any other things. Socialization means we should give confidence to the students. He can share his problems, and he should believe that the teacher can give a good solution to his problems. That is the socialization. So we can create a good socialization among the students, healthy socialization. No gender should be gender bias should be there. So every socialization can takes place in the institution itself by the teachers. So this is my another strong opinion on socialization. Next is the self-management. Really, everyone should be able to manage by herself or himself. This is more important. Right from time management, everything, we teachers should taught how to manage the time, how to complete the task in time, how to be punctual, how to be honest, how to be humble. So again, here, one session I was discussing with a behavioral analyst. I was asking, sir, how to control anger? The immediate reply from that behavioral analyst, ma'am, why we should control anger? It is better to manage anger. If we do not control anger, it is better to manage anger. So management is a very broad area where everyone should be equipped to learn to personally manage everything. So this is possible. We can give an additional responsibility of internships. We can provide part-time jobs where he or she will complete the task there and will come to the classes. So time management starts from there. And meantime, they can earn for the education also, which gives they can stand on their, which gives a lot of confidence to the students to stand on their own feet. Here also, I met one of a student. He is from the Kanyakumari district and he came for an admission. He came and with a bag, with the shoulder normal school bag full of money. Ma'am, I want to join. He was not able to communicate English, nothing, but he had a wonderful zeal of studying. I want to study in Chennai, ma'am. I want to improve my communication skill. So entire 12th holidays, I was doing my work. I was earning to get a better education in Chennai so that I can move to higher levels. That boy had a wonderful zeal. What he used to do is, in the morning, he used to work in the college canteen, earn, pay the fees, and out of the final, when he was going out in the final year, he tremendously improved his communication skill, and now he is working in an office. So this is what the hard work and the self-management. He is able to manage his time. Morning he will be working, afternoon he will be attending the class. Again, whenever there is a free time in the canteen, he will be having his books on his hands and doing the works. So he also never felt shy to ask any doubts and also slowly develop the skills, whatever he had it. So this is what we have, either the he or she should be able to manage in themselves. So this plays a very prominent role to enter a corporate world. Learning, yeah, again, learning, it is about learn, unlearn, relearn. What it means is, we are learning one concept or whatever it may be. We should not stick on to that. I have learned this, I will not learn new things. Immediately, whichever does not suit our requirement, it should be discarded. That is called unlearn. And again, we have to relearn a new concept and it has to fit to the society. I can give a good example. As we teachers, we like, yeah, chalk and a real classroom. Really, I love to interact with the students. From the eyes itself, you can see whether the students is listening to us, whether he's taking notes, whether he's really thinking, or whether his mind is traveling with us. Everything can judge. But I cannot say now, during this lockdown, I cannot say, I want only real classroom. I want only real classroom. I cannot take class. We cannot say like that. At this situation, we have to learn the wonderful platforms, Google Meet, Zoom, WebEx, whatever the modes, we have to communicate to the students and we have to interact with the students. As the teachers, first we should be learning. My principal used to often say, if you want to deliver a lecture for 40 minutes, you have to prepare for 5 hours. You have to read for 5 hours. So that should be the intention of the teachers. So first, we should learn the new things. We should adapt ourselves to the new technology or whatever may be. And then only we will be able to transform our ideas, our learning things to your student. Moreover, as we teachers, we should not feel shy to learn. Really, I don't know how many of your commerce teachers are in this group. There is two broad topics, bank reconciliation statement, and also the another topic, cost and financial reconciliation topic. Where it needs a lot of memorizing capacity and it has to memorize the, that entire format. So once in 2005, I was handling a class to these final year set of students. I was taking cost. One of the students, he was doing a CA and he came to me, ma'am, there is a very shortcut to learn this cost and management reconciliation. Very, very short to do the work. We do not memorize the entire proforma. So he gave me a small trick. Really, you believe it or not, now I have taught to so many batches and I have taught to my friends. Usually during our class times also, we feel very dry. Ah, these two topics is very dry. I will leave in choice. This was the attitude. But after that small trick, what he taught me, it was given to the out to many people. And now the topic is made very, very, very quite interesting. So as we teachers, we should learn and also make the students to learn. So again, I will say one thing. If your classes are interesting, definitely students will attend your class, will sit in your class, will definitely learn good qualities from you. So we have to make the classes quite interesting and make the students to sit inside the class. Again, from my experience, I would like to quote one, I would like to share one of my experiences. Again, normally I used to handle the classes for final years. I was handling a paper called cost accounting for the final years. Once I entered, there was a boy, very handsome, but very casual, very lethargic. He was not attentive in the class. Then after my class hours are over, I called that student and I asked, hey, what is your problem? You have a good, very, you are speaking very good English. You have very good knowledge. You are looking handsome, but you are not attentive. And at that time, he had nearly 15 papers of arrears also. So I was discussing with him, hey, what made you to this? Because he belonged to a family where there was no financial crisis at all. His brother was staying in abroad. His father was a very good, is having a very good position. So he don't have any financial scarcity or nothing. So he don't have any responsibility in the family. That made him a very lethargic attitude. Then I started interacting with that boy. Within 1 or 2 days, he started listening to my class. And then he told, ma'am, really the accounts is very, very interesting. And I gave a lot of interactions with him. Finally, on that test semester, he cleared the 15 papers at one shot. Now he is working as a HR, head of the department in a very, very reputed institution. Often in thousands of people, he used to give me as an example. My teacher made me to reach this position. Today also morning, he messaged me, ma'am, all the best, do well. That was the thought. That was the reciprocation I'm getting from my students. As the teachers, first make the students to listen to you, then whatever the qualities you want to impact, you can give the students, then he will start listening everything. So teachers are really God. They can impact a lot of things to the students. Then technology savviness. Really, this technology, everything has been technological today. The world is full of technology, and I feel that every students of this generation are really having shrewdness on applying this technology. To be honest, we, the older people, are not able to cope up with this technology. Whether you believe it or not, during the month of March, I was a little bit outdated. I don't know how to get into the Zoom or Google Meet, whatever it may be. Slowly, I learned how to mute, how to message, how to give a question in the chat box. Slowly, I learned. And now, after that, last month, I, as a head, as the dean, I organized a 6 days FDP. And really, we got nearly overwhelming responses from various states. And it was a wonderful session. And again, 6 days, it taught me a good lesson how to operate this technology. Now, really, I'm able to deliver the lecture through technology using the Zoom. Really, this is technology saving us. We should be ready to update ourselves. We should have interest. We should update. We should learn. Then only we will be able to do the work. As a teacher, we can make the students, we can impact the students, we can give a certificate courses like whatever related fields in technology. If it is a biochemistry, we can give micro transcriptions, or if it is a commerce field, we can give a tally coaching. So whatever the field related, we can give the technological knowledge also to these students apart from academic through certificate courses. Now the MOOC is also offering a lot of courses, so we can guide the students to attend these courses, online classes, MOOC courses, everything, and make the students updated. So this is also possible only through the guidance of a teacher. Now, these are all the basic skills which students require to enter a corporate world. Say, I have discussed a lot of skills. These are the major important skills: personality, communication, teamwork, self-management, technology savviness, everything, whatever, hard work, commitment, everything. So apart from this, there are some basic manners, we call this as etiquettes, which a corporate field requires. So we can train them how to dress. So I've given a picture which is right, which is wrong. So how to neatly dress and how to enter a corporate life. So we can train them whenever there is a conferences or seminar. We can ask the students to dress in a formal dress code. We can give a training, especially starting from the pants or shirts or whatever may be the footwear. Everything we can give them the guidance and ask them to dress properly and enter the do the conference or whatever the work we have given. So we have some executive etiquettes also. So we should not share the offensive jokes. We should speak in a proper pitch and tone. Whatever I told in the earlier itself, it is a mandatory to respond to the mails. That is a basic etiquette one should learn. So that will help us to create a good interpersonal relationship. Then we have even a dining etiquettes, how to eat, how to keep the spoons, what we want to do, everything. We can learn that dining etiquettes also. Again, we have a meeting etiquette. If you want to attend a meeting, definitely we should have a notepad and pen to note the things. Now, moreover, whenever we enter the meeting hall, we should mute the mobile phones, and we should not distract noises and it should not affect the other person. So these are all the basic few etiquettes which the corporate world requires. See, if you go for a professional course in CA or ACS, at the end of the completion of finals, they have this training for etiquette, separate sessions for the etiquette trainings also. As teachers, whatever we know, we can train them, we can teach the etiquettes, manners, and make the students to enter the corporate world. The journey definitely will be a very smooth one. Now, I told, as a teacher, we have a corporate social responsibility, and we have to impart not only the knowledge, we have to develop the culture, good attitude, good behavior. So, a teacher should be a role model to the students. He or she should be a punctual to the classes. That will create, that teacher will come in time. So that will create punctuality among the students. He should be committed. He or she should be honest. These are all the qualities the student will admire from the teachers and will learn automatically. This does not need a teaching sessions, but ultimately taking a teacher as a role model, the students will learn from the teacher. So these are all the few qualities. We should be a role model to the students. Always, whenever taking classes, please give real life connections so that he or will be motivated and encouraged and will learn, will adapt to these situations. Always don't criticize the students, encourage the students. If he or she, this is the adolescent age where he or she would misbehave or do some mistakes, immediately don't scold them. Call them, give a counseling, identify what is the problem, give solutions and encourage. Definitely he or she will travel in the right track. So whenever he or she joins, first ask him what is his goal. If he wants to join, everyone will have a dream. I want to join Google. I want to join this industry or whatever it is. Ask them to write it throughout this graduation period. Give assignments and whatever it may be. The student should travel, should do the projects, complete the task. Everything should be related to that organization. At the end of the final year, definitely he will have more information of the organization and he can make fit to that particular corporate sectors. Especially the teacher is a guardian, he is a protector. In Tamil, we used to say Mata, Pita, Guru, Devam. See, we need not be a god, at least we can be a friend. Whatever the problems he has, we have to support and we should not be a troubleshooter. Often I would like to share one thing. So whenever there is a parents-teachers meeting, the students will come and, ma'am, I don't want to bring my parents. Why, ma? I will ask, why, ma? Immediately they will reply, ma'am, you people will give start complaining about me, ma'am. Then I will get a lot of scoldings from the family. I will give assurance, ma, don't, we will not complain anything. So you please bring your parents. We want to see your parents. Once the parents come and if you're not communicating, ultimately the next day onwards, the boy or girl will behave properly in the classes because we have not complained them. Instead of complaining, give counselings so that he or she will definitely travel along in your line so that he can go to the corporate in a very, very, very good manner. Finally, I would share, these are all the few questions which are very, very essential for a corporate world. Intelligence questions. Intelligence question is, we know that is a one or one should have the problem solving skills or whatever the memorizing capacity. Everything plays a very, very dominant role. So here you can train, you can attain lot of aptitude tests and a lot of thinking solutions, and that you can develop the intelligent quotient. The second one is the emotional quotients. Here it is, be patient, be humble, be honest, be commitment. These are all the measurement of the emotional quotient. This emotional quotient reflects the character of a person. The third one is the social quotient. This social quotient is building a interpersonal relationship, building a teamwork. I told already this is more important for a corporate world. So this social quotient is more important for a person. See, if a person do not have intelligent quotient, but having very well this emotional and social quotient, he can go to the higher positions. If a person is not having emotional and social quotient, but having intelligence, will be stagnant in the same positions. This, rather than the intelligent quotients, EQ and SQ are more important for a corporate sector. The last one is the adversity quotient, which is that life, the corporate life is full of challenges, full of tough path. So we have the student should be in a mindset to face the challenges. He or she should not go to depression. I'm not able to solve this. He or she should not go to the depressions. He should be able to solve and come out of that problems and should be able to face the challenges. That is the adversity quotient. So everyone, as a teachers, we can make the students to train the emotional quotient, social quotient and adversity quotient and make them to fit into the corporate world. Really, my strong thought is a teacher is not only a teacher. He teaches, we can to teach each. That is the important abbreviation of a teacher. He has to take care of every individual, not a mass teaching. He has to take care of each and individual students and identify the talents, whatever the problems, give solutions, mold them, trigger them, and we can make them to travel a wonderful journey throughout their life. So teacher is a thinker, he is a mentor, he is a problem solver, he is a guide, he is a friend, he is a communicator, he is a passionate, he is an advisor, he is a leader, he is a role model. Here I would like to say Bharati has seen Kannan as a friend, philosopher, guide, mentor, everything. So a teacher also plays such wonderful role in every student's life, because majority of the students spend the time in the school or college campus where they learn a lot from the teachers. As we teachers, definitely we can mold the students and track them. Only then the student's journey to the corporate life will be very, very happy and very, very pleasurable. I would conclude with these words. Do not prepare the road for the children. Prepare the children for the road. Really, as we teachers, we can plan. So please, my humble request is not to stick on to the time bounding. Please, apart from your academic, you can impact lot of things to the students and make them students to fit into the corporate life. Definitely, you'll be able to face the challenges and go to the higher positions. Again, I would share one small example because I don't want to take much of your time. One of my students, I was handling classes during 98 and 2001, that boy completed, and now he's working as a manager in Qatar Airways. After a long time, 10 years or 15 years, I received a call from that boy. I asked him, how you got my number? After 10 to 15 years, yeah, you went abroad, you don't have any connectivity. So how you got my number? He told, ma'am, I was searching in the Chennai College's websites. So once I remember the college name. So I was searching in the website and I contacted the office people and I saw your photograph and I asked the reception to give you a number. So that was the role of a teacher. If we really impress the mind of the students, as I said in the earlier, this will not stop. This will not have an end at all. We can communicate a lot of things to the students' community and we can build a nation, a very good nation. So I would like to thank Father and also the organizing secretary, James Sir, and also Professor Raja and all the head of the department and his team for giving me this wonderful opportunity to share my experiences to the participants. I also thank Gopi Sir. Really, the technological support was very, very good. So they started, they gave 2 to 3 trials and they are very, very, the organizing committee has done a wonderful job. Well-organized thing, sir. Thank you, Raja, sir. Thank you, James, sir. Thank you, Gopi, sir. Any questions? Participants, any questions?
Dear participants, if you have any queries, you can ask.
Any questions?
Unmute yourself and ask the questions one by one, please.
Any questions from the audience?
Otherwise, you can type in the chat box also. We will explain. If there is no questions, we will go for a vote of thanks. Thank you, madam, for your enlightened and informative presentation.
Sir,
your speech was really enlightened us. I hope the participants also will enjoy. Now I invite Mr. Ashik Ahmed, Assistant Professor of Commerce of our college, to deliver the vote of thanks.
Very good afternoon, and all. I am indeed grateful to management, especially our principal, Reverend Father Dr. A. Siluvai Muthu, for guiding us and supporting in all our endeavors. It is my core duty to thank our resource person, Dr. R. Geeta, Dean School of Commerce, Associate Professor and Dean of Commerce, Guru Nayak College, Autonomous, Chennai, for accepting our invitation to be the resource person, for addressing and participant in inspiring and motivating manner. And I extend my thank to our Assistant Professor I. James R. for give chief guest introduction. I thank our HOD and faculty members for their help and cooperation. And also, I express my sincere thank to media technicians, Mr. Krishnan and team office and other staff members. Finally, I would like to thank all participants from different era for spending their valuable time with us. Once again, I thank you to all.
Dear participants, the feedback link will be posted in the chat box. You will fill the feedback and get the certificates.